Hello everyone. So we're continuing with the lessons from the article, from the important article of Rabbi Ashlag, called The Gift of the Bible, or The Giving of the Bible, The Gift or The Giving of the Torah. We are on verse 12. And it says here, on verse 12, it says, the sages are asking the question, why it's so important for the Creator? How do you exactly slaughter the animal? Means, according to the Torah, there's a certain specific way to slaughter the animal if you want to eat it, so it's considered to be kosher. Again, we're not going right now into different laws, etc. But some people think that the Torah is like teaching you how to be religious. But Rabbi Ashlag teaching us that the Torah is teaching you how to be spiritual. And the sages are saying that every detail of the Torah and all the instructions from God are only to teach you not to teach you, how only to help you to go through spiritual cleansing. In Hebrew, it's called tzoref. Tzeruf means spiritual cleansing. It's like the person that you know, create jewelry and everything. First of all, he need to make sure that the gold or the silver is clean from all the different other metals that may be, you know, mixed with the gold. The same way, if we really want to express the true nature of our soul, we have first of all to clean our soul. And the reason why God gave us the Torah is because the Torah have unique energy, unique light, that can help us to clean ourselves, to go through spiritual cleansing, to clean ourselves from the desire to receive for the self alone, from selfishness. That's the only reason, the only purpose in the, you know, of the Torah. And Rabbi Ashlag says here on verse 12, when a baby is born, is in the lowest level of consciousness. Because the baby is only focused on self-love. All the movements that the baby is doing, it's only in order to take, to receive, without any sparks of sharing or caring with anyone. It's the baby, the little baby, he is, crying if he have a little kind of pain, or some gas in his stomach, he can cry so loud just because he is a little bit not comfortable. It would wake up the entire house and would wake up the entire neighborhood. But the little baby don't think at all that maybe his parents didn't sleep already for a few days, in a proper kind of sleep. It don't have any consideration to anyone. The little baby, Rabbi Ashlag says here in verse 12 of the gift of the Bible, only think about himself and focus on, you know, what he can take. I'm hungry, or I have gas in the stomach, or I'm, you know, teeth coming out, crying and yelling just to take, without any consideration of anyone. And Rabbi Ashlag says, that's the lowest level possible of a human being. And that's why the little baby is in that state, is the most far away, further away from the Creator. Because the Creator, the Holy One, blessed be He, His entire thought is only sharing, only caring for others. God don't have any spark at all of what's in it for me, what I'm thinking here. God don't have that. God only have desire to share. That's it. Desire to influence endless love. And we already learned the law that Rabbi Ashlag is teaching us. The law says that if you, you know, if you behave like God, more you behave like God, closer you are to God. How God behaves, we just learned. Pure love, pure care, without any self-interest, without any self-agenda, without anything of what's in it for me. So the baby is, you know, further away from the Creator, because we learned from Rabbi Ashlag that if you behave the opposite of God, more you think about yourself and focus on what's in it for me and how can I take, it makes you further and further away from God. It's created a distance between you and God. And Rabbi Ashlag says here, that's why the baby in that state is the lowest level of spirituality possible. But as the baby starts to grow, right, he starts to receive lessons from his surrounding, from people around him, about caring for others, about sharing and influence good for others. Maybe it's his parents that teaching him that. Maybe his brothers and sisters, siblings, maybe kindergarten, at school. But, you know, people around him will tell the little boy or the little girl, what about some sharing? You know, maybe you can share a little bit with your toys, with your brother or sister or friends. You know, don't just eat candies just for you. Also, ask other kids, maybe they would like as well. So the surrounding, the people around, they are the one that's starting to teach and educate and help the little kid to start to realize there's also a world out there. It's not just about what I'm taking from the world out there, it's also what I'm giving to the world. But Rabbi Ashlag says it's depend on how much the surrounding means, how much the parents, for example, or the teachers understand the importance of sharing and giving. And they actually developed spiritually, and they actually living a life of caring and sharing with others. That's how much the kid would be able to observe it and receive it from his surrounding and grow toward that higher level of consciousness. But Rabbi Ashlag says, in the beginning you start to educate the kid to do the Torah and Mitzvot. Torah and the Mitzvot, what are they? We learned Rabbi Ashlag, Rabbi Akiva said, the entire Torah is caring for others. Love the neighbor as thyself. So yes, you start to teach the kid about caring for others and sharing. But the education that we all got, and also that's how kids being educated, to do good things for others. Let's say, you know, you tell your daughter, would you like to wash the dishes? Okay, and you know, what I'll get for it? You know, so you'll tell her, if you'll wash the dishes, you can watch the movie, right? Or something like that. Means we're educating our kids that if they'll do good things, if they'll share, they'll get something in return. You know, they'll bring good grades, and then they'll get a little kind of gift or things like that. We all got educated like that. That's why when we're sharing and when we're caring and doing good things for others, usually it comes, if we're honest with ourselves, usually it comes with expectations. You know, maybe we don't admit, maybe we tell ourselves, no, I don't want anything in return. I only want to sharing to do good, right? Yeah, maybe we can tell it to ourselves, but usually we don't always see exactly the expectations or, you know, the fact that we actually want something in return. We're not always aware so much about it. But the way that we're living a life, we are sharing, and, you know, if we're sharing with our, you know, wife or husband, we love to share. But then if they don't share with us, or they don't care about us when we expect them to, then we're disappointed. So we're remembering what we actually did for them, and we're actually reminding them, remember, I did for you so much. Can't you care for me one time that I need that care, that consideration, that sensitivity from you? Sensitivity means, you know, that's how we all educated. That we're caring, but we'll get something out of it. Either in this world, means I'm doing something from the other for the person. I can even be a great worker at work, and then I'll get a bonus, or a raise, or a promotion, or something like that, right? Or respect for my kids, or different things. That means that I'm actually receiving things in this world. But there is also things that I want from the world to come. What is the world to come? The world to come is not necessarily after a person dies, and then he experiences the world to come. The world to come means that I'm actually doing good things in life, and I'm sharing and caring, and I'm expecting God to give me things. So sometimes people do a lot of good things in sharing and actions of mercy. And if they, God forbid, have a crisis in their life, or even, God forbid, a disease or something like that, they can be very disappointed. They can think, God, how can it be? All my life I did good things. How can it be that that's what I'm experiencing? Means even the actions that we do for others and we're waiting that God will provide his blessings in return, that's also considered to be desire to receive. You still think of what's in it for me. And what we learned? We learned that each time that you're thinking in your consciousness, what's in it for me, how can I receive? It's actually create a distance between you and God. Why? Because that's the law. The law says that two opposites, if there's dissimilarity, it's actually, you know, bring you further away. That's the law. And if we're thinking about receiving in any form, in any way or form, it will disconnect us from the Creator. So it's considered to be, Rabbi Ashlag explains, it's considered to be in Hebrew, we call it Shelo Lishma, that you're actually doing good actions of sharing, but not for the right purpose, not for the right reason, not for the right sake. That's how they call it. But still, you still need to educate your kids like that. And in the beginning, we need to get educated like that, because it's impossible to jump, to get to a level that I'm just doing actions of sharing pure love without anything in return. We can't just jump to that level. We have, first of all, to do things still with expectations. And then we can grow to a higher level of consciousness, to the highest level of consciousness, which is pure giving and pure love and pure influencing good. But Rabbi Ashlag says that as you grow, as you learn, as you study, eventually you can get to that level called Lishma, that you're actually doing actions of sharing and caring and influencing good with the right consciousness, with a pure consciousness, only to share, only to give, only to love, only to reveal light. And as Rabbi Ashlag calls it, only to give pleasure to the Creator. What does it mean to give pleasure? What does it mean to give pleasure to the Creator? Rav Ashlag says that that's the ultimate level of sharing. And, you know, the same way that we, you know, kids, let's say a kid can bring great grades, and he knows, oh, you know, my parents told me if I bring great grades, I'll get some money, I'll get some gifts. There's something I'm going to get, you know. So it's bringing a lot of motivation to work hard and to study a lot for the great grades. But if the kid says to himself, I want to bring great grades, excellent grades, because I know how much it will make my parents feel fulfilled and happy and joyful, and that's why I'm doing it. Right? So this kind of giving and sharing, it's pure. It's without anything in return. Just all what I want to give pleasure to my parents. And also the kid received tremendous joy, much more than the gift that he would get. So the same way in our life, we can do a lot of good things and think about how it will benefit me in this way or another, from people or from the Creator. And we can get and elevate ourselves to a higher level of consciousness, which means that we actually doing actions of sharing and positive things just because I know how much it makes God happy and joyful. Because think that, let's say there's a kid that grow and he really kind of, you know, he's a successful person, became a successful person, makes a lot of money, and wow, he's like amazing, so successful. But everything is just for himself, he's just taking, make tons of money, and he buy this, he buy that, he's like, so great. It's bring joy to his parents that he's successful and indeed amazing things. But imagine that that kid actually wants to be more successful and more and more and make more money and more money, but for what reason? Just so he can help more people in the world, he can make a difference in the world, he can save the world, he can really influence the world in a positive way. That's the only reason why he wants to be more and more successful. Now, the joy that his parents would feel is such a deeper kind of joy. So much more joy. Because the reason why he's making so much effort is only to do more good. And he knows that that's really what he would make his parents happy. And that's why he's doing it. So in life, we can be successful and have a lot of amazing things. Great. It makes God happy that I'm happy. Yes, I'm his kid. God is our father. And the father wants to see his parents happy, for sure. But it would make the father or the mother much more happy and fulfilled if the kid actually wants to do good and to help other people. And to really do things that help people to, you know, to be connected to the light. And that's why, you know, what's supposed to be in our consciousness, that I want to help many people possible, to really help them in their life, to really help them to be connected to the Creator, because that's the joy of God. The joy of God is that all the people in the world will be connected to him. All the people in the world will be positive. All the people in the world would wake up in the morning with thoughts of sharing and caring for others. That's the joy of God, because the joy of God is that he can give from himself his endless love to everyone. But if we are blocked and we're only thinking about ourselves, God cannot give us his endless love. But if we open ourselves and receiving his light for the sake of sharing, then God can give us his endless love again. And if we're teaching more and more people in the world how to receive from the Creator, who is the unique consciousness of receiving for the sake of sharing, now God can give His endless love to all humanity, to all the souls, in an unlimited way. And that's the ultimate thought of sharing, that I'm sharing with the consciousness of giving pleasure to the Creator. The Maimonides said, Maimonides, he was, he lived a thousand years ago. He said that you need to have a certain level of consciousness to get to a place that you purely just want to share without anything in return. I just want to reveal light. I just want to do good. I just want to help another human being. Just want to help the world. I just want to give pleasure to God. You need like spiritual muscles for that. You don't just get there. You need to build yourself to get there. And people that don't study, in the old times, women didn't study the Torah, and also children. Today, thankfully, it's changed. Women learn and kids learning. But if you don't study regularly, you cannot just jump to get to a level, because the Torah helps you to build your spiritual muscles. Today, we all can get there already, because we're all studying. The knowledge is available. We can get there. And the Kabbalah says, if you study, even if you do things of sharing, not with the pure consciousness of just sharing, but you really want to get to that level. You know, I'm not there, but I want to get there. That's my goal. I want to get to that level, that place I can just, receive for the sake of sharing in a pure way. You'll get there, because you want to get there. And Rabbi Ashlag continued to say toward the end of number 12 that within the Torah there is a unique light. Unique light that God injected within the Torah. That if you, the sage says, that God says, I created the evil inclination, and I created the Torah, which is a remedy, like a medicine, right? Means what? What is the evil inclination? The evil inclination is the thought within us that tells us what's in it for me, what I'm gaining from it. That even if you're doing an action of sharing, he's coming into your mind and forcing you to think, how are you going to gain something out of it? So your sharing would not be just pure love. That's why the evil inclination was created. So you can ask yourself, so the evil inclination play with my mind all the time. How can I get to a level that I can just purely share without all this agenda and expectations, right? So what God says, I created the Torah. Torah is like a remedy, it's like medicine. That if you study the Torah with the right consciousness, like what we just learned, then the Torah is healing you. It's like a spiritual vaccination that also heals you from the desire to receive for the self alone, from the self agenda, from the self interest. That because of that self interest, you're not really sharing purely and unconditionally, because we just learned. If you don't share unconditionally, you are still far away from God. And if you're still far away from God, you're going to have lack in your life. You're going to have some disappointment, some unhappiness, some void, some darkness in your life. Who wants that? We don't want darkness. We want just pure light. You need to work for it. How do you work for it? Get to a level that you're caring and sharing unconditionally. But just a second, the evil inclination constantly forcing me to have conditions. So what you should do? Study the Torah. Study the Zohar. Study the Rabbi Ashlag. Study the Torah. Because within the Torah, there's unique light that can help you to go through spiritual cleansing and eventually be so pure that all what you do is just purely for the sake of sharing. That's the Torah. It's a unique light. People think that the Torah, it's a religious. But truly, the Torah, sages says, it's a remedy. It's a medicine that heals you from the self-interest. If you think about it, all the problems of all humanity or all the world is the self-agenda of people. It's the self-interest. That's what blocking everything in politics, in the, you know, in the different systems, in marriage, in everything. So if that's what blocking everything, if you'll just get over it and fix that, it will fix the entire world. And Rabbi Ashlag says that as we're growing and we're pushing ourselves and we're developing ourselves more, higher and higher and higher, to a higher level of sharing, a more pure and more pure level of sharing, and you want to get to that ultimate level, eventually you get rid of all the sparks of self-love. We need to understand that self-love, selfishness, it's not something real. It's just sparks of energy that attach themselves to our soul and causing ourselves to be selfish, causing ourselves to have expectations, causing ourselves to think about what's in it for me. It's not really my soul, but because those sparks jumping and controlling my consciousness, that's why, you know, I think like that and I behave like that, and I constantly into those kind of bad movies in my mind of why this person talked to me like that, and why these people didn't give me the respect that I deserve, and why they didn't invite me to the party, and I'm so disappointed, and I'm so, you know, hurt by that. You know, and why my husband talking to me like that, and why my wife don't give me the respect that I'm expecting, right? All those sparks of what's in it for me, it's not the soul. It's sparks of energy that kind of attack my soul, suck my spiritual consciousness energy, and forcing me to fall to that trap. But if you're pushing yourself and you're working very hard spiritually, slowly and gradually, you get rid of all those negative sparks, and you clean yourself, your soul, as we just said. Suddenly you kind of thinking, what did I think? Where was my mind? It's like I was in such a bad movie. Like I was so focused on what they think about me, and you know, and how they talk to me. It's like now I realize that it's not really important. It's just, you know, I don't even need that. Don't need them to invite me to that party or to give me that kind of respect. It's not even something that I'm interested. Why? Because you're growing so much. Suddenly you see that you got rid of another spark of energy that was controlling you and caused you to be so focused on yourself. And slowly and gradually you're getting higher and higher to the level that all the movements that you make in your life are only in order to influence good, only in order to add more light in the world, only in order to heal the world and to fix the world and to help every human being in the world, and only in order that all of us together, all humanity, all the souls in the world together through our unity and love, will bring so much joy to the Creator, when the Creator will see how much we love each other and care for each other and unconditionally with each other, how much joy it will give him, because now he can give us endless love. And that's where we'll get to that level. That even the things that we must receive, because we must receive certain things, we must eat, we must drink, we must sleep, we must take a shower, but even the things that you must take will be, you know, you can eat something and say, I'm eating that thing because it will give me strength to help more people. So even things that you must receive, your thought, your consciousness will be purely so I can use it in order to help more, to reveal more light, to do more good. That's why the sages said all the Torah and all the precepts, the mitzvot, were given to us just so we can spiritually clean ourselves. That's it. So we finish today number 12. Next time we'll continue with number 13. By the way, if you would like to receive those lessons that I'm teaching each time from the articles, the most amazing and important articles of Rabbi Ashlag, I'll be happy to send them to you. Just send me your email address and I'll send them to you. And by the way, if you have friends or family that would like to join, they can also, you know, you can send me their email address. You see that what we're learning here, it's not that complicated. You don't need to have a background of learning Kabbalah or anything. Every human being can understand those things. It's simple. And it can help so much. Rabbi Ashlag says that he got this message, this knowledge from God, because in our generation, we are a generation that the knowledge of Kabbalah was waited for our generation. Because our generation is not like any other generation ever. And in our generation, we need the knowledge of Kabbalah in order to actually handle everything that's happening around us in a successful way. And without this knowledge, it's impossible, because the pressure that exists in life and the things that people need to handle every day is just so intense. The knowledge of Kabbalah is a gift that God gives us to our generation, so we can actually handle everything and actually learn how to enjoy from everything that's happening, despite the stress and the intensity. And that's why I really recommend more and more people to join these lessons. So, you know, you can send me their emails as well. And, you know, we'll be happy to send. So thank you, everyone. Till next time.